So in this video we'll discuss about the timber designing, okay, and in this video basically we'll discuss about the column design for the timber section. So before that, at page number 13 of IS 883, you can see column, okay, and there is three types of column: solid column, built up column or box column we can say, and the final is spaced column. Spaced column and solid columns are similar. The design procedure is same, but a new term is introduced in spaced column. We'll talk about that later. Starting with the solid column, it is further classified as three types, that is short column, intermediate column and long column. So will be for the box and built up column: short column, intermediate column, long column. And so will be for spaced column: long column, short column, intermediate column. The condition for short column and intermediate column is given as S by D should not exceed as 11. So here S by D is the S is the span of the column and D is the depth, and this value is determining whether the column is short, intermediate or long. In case of box or built up column, you will see a new term introduced here, D1 and D2. These are the values, or these are D1 and D2, okay. You can find it, what does it mean, at page number 1 of IS 883. So small D1 and D2, D1 is the least overall width of the box in mm and the least overall dimension of core in box in mm. So these are the terms we have to understand. So these are the condition to satisfy whether the beam is short, intermediate or long column. Now I have a question here. Design a deodar column 4 meter long to carry an axial load of 300 kilonewton. So the design procedure you will be same for various types of question. Given area has to be calculated first, okay. For this I have been given the load 300 kilonewton, and for deodar column, so for deodar, okay, we have at page number 9 of table 1, I find the values for average unit mass, modulus of elasticity, okay. So deodar of Himachal Pradesh, rho will be taking as 557 kg per meter cube, and modulus of elasticity is taken as 94.8 into 10 to the power 2 newton per mm square. This has to be corrected in this table. Similarly, we will have to take the value for sigma cp, which is here compression parallel to grain, and you have three conditions: inside location, outside location and wet location. If nothing is described in question, then you will take for the inside location. And so for inside location deodar, we find 7.8 newton per mm square. So sigma cp is equal to 7.8 newton per mm square. Please do not get confused. In code you will find sigma cp as fcp, and further I will be giving l for the length when in the code you are provided with s. So this is the general thing you have to remember while watching this video. Now for area, we have a formula that load is given by area multiplied by sigma cp, okay. Then we get area required as 300 kilonewton by sigma cp as 7.8. this is in kilonewton and this is in newton per meter, so multiplying by 1000, we get area required as 38461.5 mm square. Assuming, this is a step you have to know, assuming a square column, that means all the dimension will be same. Area is equal to b square is equal to d square, or b is equal to, will get as 196.11 mm. Here provide b nearly equal to 250 mm, that will be equal to depth of the beam, depth of the column. So b, and provide 250 mm by 250 mm column. This is the general procedure. Now we have to check whether this is a short column, intermediate column or long column. we know. To check whether it is a short column or long column or intermediate column, we need a ratio of L by D, where L is the length, or you can find in the book and the code as S, okay, L by D, which is 4 meters, so keeping in mm, 4000, by depth, which is 250. I get this value as 16, okay. And if you check the condition for short column, it says, so this is a case of solid column, and for short column S by D should not exceed 11, and our value has come 16, so it doesn't satisfy the condition of short column. And for intermediate column, it should be between 11 and K8 is a constant which we'll find with the formula which is provided at the appendix, okay. And for long column, the value should be greater than K8. So let us find K8, which is a constant equal to 0.702. This is a mistake in the code books. 0.702 under root E by FCP. FCP is value equal to sigma CP. So K8 is equal to 0.702 E by la modulus of elasticity sigma CP, 0.702 E, that is 94.8 into 10 to the power 2 by 7.8. okay, we have calculated the value from the table, so this comes as 24.47, and L by D does not exceed 24.47, that is the value lies between 11 and 24.47, that is K8. Hence it is a intermediate column. If it is an intermediate column, then again looking in the code book, for intermediate column, the permissible compressive stress is calculated by using following formula, that is FC is equal to FCP 1 minus 1 by 3 S divided by K8 into D to the power 4. So FCP, which we have taken from the table, S is the length, K8 is we have calculated, and D is the depth. So if we see, we have just calculated the S by D term, that is L by D here, okay. Therefore sigma CP dash, okay, in code book you find it this as sigma CP dash, is equal to FCP, or you can just write as sigma CP, 1 minus 1 by 3 L by K8 D to the power 4. Sigma CP is 7.8, 1 minus 1 by 3 L is 4000 in terms of mm, K8 is 24.47, and D is 250 to the power 4, then we get this value as 7.32, okay. Then we can calculate load carrying capacity, that is design strength of the timber. Load carrying capacity will be equal to sigma CP dash, this is sigma CP dash, multiply by the area, okay. Sigma CP dash is 7.32 Newton per mm square multiply by area, that is 38461.5 mm square, and we get this value as 452.77 kilonewton. Okay, I have converted into kilonewton, which should be greater than the axial load acting on the section, which is okay. So it is safe to provide 250 into 250 column to carry 300 kilonewton load. So this is a type of numerical related to design column, a design of the column of timber section.